have spent the last few months religiously following the Britney Spears conservatorship battle. Like, I know some people are also, but not everybody knows what's really going on. So today I'm going to be taking you through the story of the conservatorship battle of Britney Spears. Besides following Britney Spears on Instagram, which I do, I also watched the documentary produced by the New York Times on the conservatorship battle, and I read the articles corresponding with it. I also read the articles by the New Yorker and by the Rolling Stones. I doubt that many people find themselves in tricky legal battles with their parents, but it's not really what's so relevant about the story. It's more about how Britney is fighting for something that she deserves, which is a big thing that's been going on in our country lately. Many people who are standing up and finally voicing their opinions on what they actually deserve. And so today I'll be taking you through the main points of the story, which is the beginning of the conservatorship, the rules that Britney now has to follow while under the conservatorship, and of course, what's been being done to end the conservatorship. So in 2008, Britney's estranged father, Jamie Spears, gained full control over her finances and life using a conservatorship. The conservatorship was put in place by the Spears family after a 5150 emergency psychiatric hold was called on Britney in January of 2008 after an incident with her and her husband, ex-husband, Kevin Federline. The conservatorship was granted after 10 minutes with a judge, and Britney was not brought to the court. The whole thing was granted without her even being there or saying how she felt. So Britney's struggles were just beginning in 2008 because she was now going to have to spend 15 years under a conservatorship that was originally supposed to only be temporary. In the 15 years that Britney's been under the conservatorship, she has had to do anything that the conservators have said to her. This includes all of her spending, all of her communications, and all of her personal decisions. They have to go through her conservator and be approved. Spears has alleged that they have gone as far as prescribing her lithium against her will, forcing her to keep in her IUD so she can't have any more children. She's not allowed to have any more. She's not allowed to get married. And she has absolutely no control over her finances. None whatsoever. She has to be approved to use her money. According to a member of Britney Spears' sort of go squad, all decisions about Britney are made every Thursday at noon with a team of about 10 people who are responsible for her life. This goes from her business affairs, her public relations, social media, merchandising, songs licensing. All of that is done without Britney being there. Every week, she's not allowed to come. She just has to deal with whatever their decisions are. After spending all of these years under the thumb, basically, of the conservatorship, Britney has, as of 2019 and most of this year, been fighting the conservatorship to try and make her situation better. So on April 27th of 2021, the Spears legal team, which is Britney's, began to fight so Britney would finally be allowed to speak and testify in court against her conservatorship. Since then, she has also been granted that right. Another right that she's been granted, which she has never been able to have before, is Britney has been given the right by the Los Angeles Court of Appeals to choose her own judge for the continuing of the conservatorship battles. Since the beginning, Britney has only been allowed judges appointed by either the court or by her conservators, and now she finally can pick one that chooses and fights only for her. Britney has stated, as this year's gone on, she has stated that, "I'm here to get rid of my dad and charge him with conservatorship abuse." She is not willing to back down from this without a fight. I spent years believing that Britney Spears was a crazy drug addict prone to self-destruction, And since learning some more about her conservatorship and what she's going through, I realize how much pain Brittany has gone through, from being in a psychiatric hold to losing control of her choices and her children. And now she's finally gaining control and fighting for the peace of what she deserves. I never thought of Brittany as an inspiration when I was younger, but now that I know her pain and struggle, I can truly see what a powerful woman she is. Free Brittany.